wolf pack. Alright, so terror in the streets over here, okay? Oh, do bomb arrows not work in the rain? That is something I did not even consider. Am I using the right bow? No, I'm not. I'm trying not to waste the last bits of that bow. That's not even something I possibly considered being a possibility. Is that bomb arrows wouldn't work in the rain. That's cool though, I like it. Razor shroom. Cool. It would make sense because you're kind of setting them on fire, right? Did I set a pin on that one, or did I set a pin on a different one? No, I set a pin on that one. Okay. See, Death Mountain looming in the distance. We're kind of coming closer in on that one. Nah, I'm good. Thanks, though. I'm done fighting you guys for right now. It's an interesting place to build a town. Whatever happens if your land bridge breaks? How do you get off? Terrytown. Well, at the very least, I see the town. Yeah, I see the building in the background. That they're trying to build their new modular buildings that are built with duct tape and nails. Hey. We meet again. Who are you again? I'm one of the Bolson construction contractors. The name's Hudson. I remember. Me too. What are you doing? Since I've been transferred here, I've decided to build a village from scratch. Every village needs a name, though. I think I'll call it Terrytown. Goodbye. Good idea. However, what's wrong? I built a house to store the village supplies in, but there just isn't enough. Enough what? Enough anything. People, money, stuff. I'll help out. But why? There's nothing in it for you. I don't mind. I've got nothing to do. I buy houses because I'm bored. You're a lifesaver. Well, I suppose to get started, we'll need houses for people to live in. We can't invite them until we have homes. Do you think you can bring me 10 bundles of wood? If you bring me that, I can combine it with what I've already got and get started on new houses. I think if I'm not mistaken, I already have 10 bundles of wood. I've got 11. There you go. I brought them. Sure. You're a lifesaver. Well, next is... These boulders are driving me nuts. I want to move them out of the way so we can develop the land underneath. It'd really help me out if you could find someone with enough brute physical strength to bust them apart. Physical strength? Yeah, if we're talking about brute physical strength, then we are. A Goron would be my first choice. Good luck, you'll need it. This seems like a real long shot. Oh, and one last wrinkle. In accordance with the official Bolson construction policy, that someone's name must end in Sun. If you run into anyone that fits with what I've said, send them here to Terrytown for me. So we've seen one Goron. I'll, just out of curiosity later, go check his name, but I doubt that's going to be him. I doubt they're going to let us steal him. You clearly intend to build a very small village here. You can't fit very much. But that's not terrible, I guess. Let's go see the inside of the one house you built so far. Hmm. Another iron sledgehammer to add to my ranks. I like the deck. It's very nice. And the whole, like, they built it around a tree thing, I've always liked those. Those are kind of cool. I bet this is probably his house, though. Oh, I think that's a recipe. Let's take a picture of it. So you mix... I think that's prime. That's the prime raw meat. And the goat butter and the rice and milk. And you get that. We will have to try that. I don't have any goat butter and milk. Or rice, actually, but I can get rice easy enough. We'll have to try that. It's nice enough. Cannot climb up. There we go. Alright, so, little tiny town out here, Terrytown. I don't really have a good warp point near here, though. Because Great Fairy Fountain doesn't have a warp point. I guess this would be the warp point. Or I could go to the tower. The tower would be a good warp point as well. Oh, there's a stable over there, too. That one's pretty far off, though. I probably want to go to the tower to get to that one. So is that red one as well. I didn't realize how far off that was. Let's go to the bay over here. This thing looks kind of cool. And a peaceful little lake. Ooh, hello there. Excuse me while I press all of the wrong buttons. It's very clear water. I like it a lot. You can see the bottom very easily. Oh, look at that! The weight of the chest actually weighs down this too. I really dig the amount of physics that goes into this kind of thing. So I think I'm gonna break my leaf before long because I keep hitting this chest. Yeah, get out of here. Any of you are Hyrule Bass, I would like to have you. Actually, no, I found a really good fishing technique. Watch this. I like this one. It's redneck fishing right there. It's a good fishing technique. I recommend it to everyone. Feel free to take my idea if you so choose. Actually only interested in the Hyrule Bass right now. I'm not interested in all the imposters around here. Wow, that does a lot of damage. It's really bright for 3 a.m. Look at this. It's 3 a.m. and yet, like, the sun is rising. Well, there's clearly some points of interest on this, spiraling peninsula thing. There's some sort of shrine thing over there. One of those puzzle shrines. On an enemy camp. Here we go. Whoops. Bow breaking was not part of the strategy. These enemies are actually slightly more dangerous in the water than they're out of it. Come on. This is how you do the damage on him. Just spin. Treasure around here. I bet we could make it all the way there if I just equip my Zora armor. Let's do that. Just avoid all of this entirely. I'll spin if they get close. Oh no, he shot water at me while I'm swimming through the water. What a dangerous attack. I'm completely unprepared for such a vile enemy. Watch me as I slowly swim away from all the dangers I face. And you can make it. That's actually pretty easy. All right. Not wearing the fast armor anymore. Well, there's definitely a lot of enemies around here. What if there'll be any singing birds here to tell me how to do this puzzle? Also, the other thing I'm noticing, pretty much none of these enemies have weapons, so you're not really refreshing weapons as you're going through this. That's how you get the birds.
Mipha's grace is ready.
I'm gonna need Mipha's grace in a second if I don't fight better. Come on! Get closer! Fight like you mean it! Let me sneak attack this guy. Yeah, that's how you do it. So tired of this guy. What was that move? He's gonna throw his spear at me. The greatest pleasure I've ever had in dealing with an enemy. So there's something. I'm wondering if it's going to be a similar thing to how I did that other one where I have to, jump on top of it and thrust a sword in or something. Because this would be a place you could definitely do that from, is right up here. But barring that, I'm a little short on ideas for it. Let's try it. Nah. We'll have to leave this one for another day, it seems. So, if you give me just a moment, I do have a phone call I need to take, and we'll keep heading in that direction. Alright, welcome back. Had to take that call. So anyway, the peninsula, I think it's going to be important at some point, but I'm not really sure what to do with it as of yet. So I think we're going to keep heading to that way. I still don't know where the research lab is. I'd assume it's somewhere in Akala, but I don't really know beyond that. Alright, let's put on some good clothes and just swim out of here, because this is going to take a while to walk around have to deal with all those enemies. I don't know what your grand plan is. I think he knows I'm here. Oh, right, I forgot. So, here's the thing that I found. Okay, you can shoot a bow while swimming? When did that happen? I learned that horses can swim. Okay, can we stop that? Can we stop that? I didn't know it was a thing that he could shoot while swimming, though. That's a new one. But yeah, horses can swim. I found that out. Just by, I think I got close to the water and I got too deep in. They just swim. They're cool. They call this a beach. It's not a very nice beach. It's kind of one of those like rocky, craggy beaches with just a tiny bit of sand. Not very nice beach. Akala Ancient Test Lab, there we go. And then the Fang and Bone open only at night. I don't know exactly where that's at, but... Alright. And there's a stable this way as well. I mean, we did see that stable way over there. Maybe the path loops around. I was thinking of going for the stable at some point. Not quite yet. Anyone else getting the feeling that rocks are just not even like enemy rocks, like just dangerous random rocks are gonna fall towards me? Why are these wolves all afraid of me? I mean, I guess I am dangerous, but I don't know why they initially start afraid of me. Okay, this clearly was something important. Just kind of appears to be ruins now, though. I hear Korok somewhere. Oh, hey, a person. Been a while since I've seen a person. Wait, are you one of the Yiga clan people? You look kinda Yiga clan-ish, I don't know. You guys have those weird creepy smiles. Isn't Master Koga just so dreamy? I could stare at that poochie tummy of his all day long. Master Koga? Huh? What, there's no way you don't know about him. How could anyone not know about him? Yep, he's the leader of the Yiga clan. Master of countless Sheikah secrets and sworn enemy of a hero long thought dead. Thought long dead, I'll take your life. Yeah. They all kind of have a creepy smile on their face. And I lost it in the forest. Excellent. Come on. They're too fast for me to use that move on them. There we go. That's how you do it. Pick up a vicious sickle. These things don't last very long. They're pretty weak. Yeah, there's like a temple or something here. I'm also hoping to find my boomerang in the mess of woods around here. Could have bounced off the cliff if it went far enough, but I don't know if I did. I thought I heard a Korok around here somewhere, though. Maybe not. Well, hey, another stable. Nah. Other than the enemies, it really is peaceful around this area. Everything's so bright and cheerful. It's kind of hard to believe that evil Ganon is lurking on the horizon. Ready to throw the world into chaos yet again. Let's go buy some arrows. No issues to report.
You.
Hello. I've been on patrol duty lately. The name's Haas. Jeez, it's gotten dangerous around here lately. It has. Yes. Recently I've been hearing about a suspicious guy named Kilton. He runs a shop called Fang and Bone. They say he goes around pushing some kind of cart night after night. He's been making people around here uncomfortable with the suspicious and otherworldly activity. Do you know Kilton? No, I don't. I see. Well, if you see any suspicious people, please tell me what they look like in detail. Really, if you see this Kilton character, please tell me all the juicy details. I'm counting on you. So that happens at night. We should investigate that. Hello. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen you around here. Boy, you sure have strange taste. You look like someone who's traveled willy-nilly all over the world. Who are you? Sorry, I haven't introduced myself. I'm Nobo. No, Nobo. I've traveled everywhere, but at the end of the day, I like Akala best of all. That's why I'm pretty familiar with stuff around here. Is there something you want to know? You know Hudson? Hudson? Who's that? He's a carpenter. I'm not quite sure. I've been hearing clanging and banging by Lake Akala. That's south of here. Why don't you go check it out? Okay. So if you happen to miss that, this area. Let's see. If you go west of the stable, there's a sacred place called the Spring of Power. Offer the sacred article to the Spring of Power. That's what the legend says. Maybe it was part of a ritual to the Princess of Hyrule Castle used to perform. Do they mean the fairy fountain, or is there somewhere else? I should check to the west of here as well. Farther areas. There's a lighthouse-looking home north of here. No one was there when I last stopped by, though. I wonder if that's the ancient test lab. Alright. That is good to know. Spring of Power. Said to the west. I wonder if that's what they mean right there. Ah, and you're here again. Colorful leaves gently falling. A fort that fell to the great calamity. Unspeakable sorrow surrounds this landscape. Hey, we meet again. Are you out traveling as well? I've traveled all over the world. I have a picture. Check out my album, yo. This one's gonna be a little bit hard to find. I know I've seen that spring and that goddess statue before. There's a place like this at the ruins in North Akala Valley, to the west of here. That might be the same place that she was talking about, the spring, so we should definitely head over there. It's pretty much directly west of here. I'm certain you'll be able to find it without any trouble. Yeah, we'll check that area out. Any arrow salesmen around here? Oh, I didn't even realize this. I bet a lot of these places have recipes on the wall. Well, I have made those before, I think. Just by accident. Want to keep those on hand. Rumor Mill, Volume 4. This is Tracy. I have a taste for the rumors of the world, worlds long gone and worlds yet to come. Everyone gossiping in the present world? Here's my favorite bit of the latest news. Treasures of the Falling Star. I was told the Falling Stars do in fact go away at daybreak, so I was too slow. The stars spread out in the sky like a tapestry, or tapestry, and across that expanse you see one streak of light, a shooting star. And I've heard that there's treasure waiting where these stars have landed. The next time you see one, why not track it down to see where it lands? Tracy's recommendation, 4 stars. That's good to know, though. So no beetle out here? Or am I not looking far enough? Yeah, beetle might not have made it out here. Also, this, like, slow sweeping turning shot that I'm doing is, like, the shot that they'd totally show in, like, an E3 trailer. Look at this. Yeah. That's the kind of shot you see at E3, and they... You kind of have some epic music over it. They might show it for, you know, a couple seconds, maybe, like, 3 or 4 seconds, and then... New shot. Alright, so let's go here. We'll have a nice warp point. And I guess we'll investigate the spring. I think that's what... That'd be a good idea. And I see... You see that smoke up there? At the top corner? I'm pretty sure that's the lab I need to go to. Right up there. That looks very, very tech labby. It's got smoke and everything. Tosa Og Apparatus. Hey, here we go. Alright. We're playing golf now. Ah, first try. So I noticed that looks like the exit right there, but it looks like there's more stuff behind it. Yeah, there's more behind it. I'm not ready to go yet. Let's do some more. Because that was exceptionally easy. Oh man, we're mini golfing now. Can I get a new one? No? What, one shot and you fail? That's it? That's kind of harsh. I guess they expect you to come back in and try it again. You know what? We are going to do that, though. Let's complete the shrine and then we'll come back. So I think you just go back into it, and then it gives you another ball. That's easy enough. But if you leave the view, it gets rid of your ball, so you've got to stay in the view until it actually completes the puzzle. There you go. Yeah. We'll try again. I don't know. Maybe I just misread it and the ball would come back if I went back into the view, but... Okay, this is kind of a hard way to start. Okay. Alright. Good shot, I think. Yes, good shot. Oh, it would be, except for I left the view. No, wait, no, it's there. Does it not count because I didn't stay in the view long? Oh, you can't reactivate. So this one you do legitimately have to get it in one shot. Come on. That's kind of ridiculous. I was right there, but it doesn't count. Hey, wait. It worked now. Did that always work? Maybe it did activate and I just wasn't paying attention. Anyway. After a short death later, we can now go grab our bonus chest. Hopefully it was all worth it. Great Frostblade. Ooh. That sounds... scary. It's a two-handed frost weapon. So, unlike the two-handed fire weapon I had. In holding this... So I realized the differences between holding a, you know, warm or cold weapon and getting a resistance. The resistance makes it so that you can withstand like a colder temperature or a warmer temperature. But holding the weapon actually makes you hotter or colder, which I imagine if I held a hot weapon in a hot area, I would get too hot. So this makes me very cold holding this weapon, so I couldn't use it in a cold area. Just something to keep in mind. Anyway, we will make it up there in a bit, but I do want to check out this shrine over here. It's also Skull Lake, which seems kind of spooky. So we might do kind of like a swoop up that way, maybe. Or not. It all depends on how I feel like tackling it. Slightly foreboding mountain. Ooh, hey. More flowers. Puzzle right there was trying to find the rest of them. We'll hold on to that. I'll throw it in an enemy or something. That looks kind of interesting. Be a bit of a trek to get to. More horses. Enemy. Not quite. Hmm. kind of like to get rid of all these sledgehammers. They just kind of, they just take up space, and they, I mean, they do okay damage, but, you know. Dragonbone Moblin Spear. Do, like, stabbing power. Nice, because it doesn't knock the enemy over doing the spin move. So you can just keep hitting them and without them flying away. And I've got too many weapons that I kind of consider to be, like, decent weapons. At least they look like they'd be. So I don't want to use them, but at the same time, I don't really know what to do with them. Like, they seem like rare weapons. Like, I'm only ever going to get one of that frost weapon. So I feel kind of bad using it, but at the same time, if I don't use it, what am I going to do with it? It's going to clog up my inventory with more crap. Oh, I think this is it. Yep, this is where we had a memory at. Alright. But yeah, I probably wouldn't have found this without any, you know, hints as well. It's another one without any really good landmarks in the back. It's kind of a hole in the ground.
Seeking help regarding this power that has been handed down over time. Prayer will awaken my power to seal Ganon away. Or so I've been told all my life. And yet, Grandmother heard them, the voices from the spirit realm. And Mother said her own power would develop within me. But I don't hear or feel anything. Father has told me time and time again. He always says, quit wasting your time playing at being a scholar. Curse you. I've spent every day of my life dedicated to praying. I've pleaded to the spirits tied to the ancient gods. And still the holy powers have proven deaf to my devotion. Please, just tell me. What is it? What's wrong with me?
Based on what we've seen, it definitely seems like Zelda was having a lot of trouble getting all this to work out for her. Okay, so that's coming to the end area. We're not quite at the end, but we're getting there. You've done well to find the spring. Offer Dinral's scale received from the Red Spirit to the Spring of Power. My goddess Hylia will guide you. Spring of Power. Who or what is Dinral? Yeah, that's basically what I'm at right now. What's a Dinral? Surely it wouldn't be hiding in a tree, would it? Ah, you found Dinral. It hides in the tree. Bird eggs. Whoa, what? Link, I'm gonna need you to... Do not do that. Okay, we stole their eggs. They quickly run away before they hear about it. Oh, it's just coming to a lovely area here. This seems like not the way I'd want to enter this. Dropping down from above is a much safer option. Though if it's raining like this, I don't imagine that would be easy to get out. Especially since it's waist-deep water, so I can't actually swim up. I do find that little quirk of the Zora armor to be slightly annoying. Waist-deep water isn't deep enough for you to swim in, so you can't actually use the climbing gear. You can't actually use the climb up waterfalls ability. Either way, definitely don't want to go that other way. I'm going to put on the hood, even though it's an armor loss, it looks cooler. Looks like there might be ore deposits. I don't really know why you'd want to go down there. That just seems very dangerous. So, I feel like they might be guarding something. Something important, anyway. We've also reached the base of Death Mountain, inadvertently. That's the quarry, so I guess it might be a good mining spot, maybe? Shadow Pass. Spooky. I see that one spot's on Skull Lake. You know what, actually, we're gonna go back to the shrine. We'll do this and then we'll wrap around that way. Or maybe we'll go to the island. I'd sure like to see that island. That'd actually be kind of cool. I don't have a great length on how long I'm going to do this for. I think we're close to about 2 hours or so. So we might do a little bit more exploration and then wrap it up. A little bit more being about half an hour to an hour, but you know. Explore the rest of Akala, at least the major landmarks, and then be done. And we definitely want to go to the ancient test lab. Tech lab, whatever it's called. There you go. Ooh. Enemy camp. Don't mind me. Not really an enemy camp, just one thing. Although I have noticed, it's just random wall, I have noticed a bunch of lanterns in the area. Which is making me think, especially with the inclusion of enemies for added difficulty, that there may be another one of these blue fires somewhere that I'm going to have to transport all the way up the hill. I'm just kind of getting that vibe here, I think. Because presumably they run on the same type of magic, where it's just like blue fire. Sheikah blue fire. Oh, hello, Guardian. I've been saving this stuff for a reason. Alright, we're gonna do this really cool, like, you ready? Oh god, why is it attacking? Are you dying? You are. Somewhat. I prepared for such an event. So you don't need the ancient arrows necessarily. Guardian weapons work pretty decently on them as well, especially the higher tier stuff. Though it does kind of unnerve me that so close to this place is an active guardian. And from what I understand, I believe they come back every time the Blood Moon comes back, so that's kind of unfortunate too. No real way to dispose of them permanently. Finally found it. Yep, and we're gonna have to fire the furnace. And it's raining, so firing the furnace may not happen at this current point of time. And if I'm not mistaken, that is our strange maze. And it's got a shrine in it. And I can't see much else because everything's super foggy, but the map tells me that there's lots of water, so I'm gonna trust the judgment of the map on that one. And it looks like guardians were a pretty big part of this facility back in time. There's a lot of guardians around here. Thankfully deactivated, unlike that one. It did say I could sell this guy materials, so maybe I'll be able to make a lot of money off of all of the guardian bits I have currently. It's...
Hi.
Hey, you. What are you doing here? Oh, you're Robbie. That's who I was looking for. Is that a Sheikah Slate on your belt? Pretty much. And it's... Are you the one called Link? Yes, I am. It's too bad. If you were the legendary Link, there would be something important I need to tell you. Oh, is this the trope of the old person can't hear well? How can I determine with full certainty whether you are the true hero? Yes, how indeed, Yes, if you show me the wounds your body suffered 100 years ago, that should prove you're truly Link. Show him the wounds. So what, you want me to just go and, like, beat myself up out in the field somewhere? Jump off a cliff? Who are you? Unless you're an acquaintance of Robbie's, I can't talk to you. Trade secrets, you know.